Welcome back to our series on ADAS calibrations with the Hunter, ADASLink, and the DAS 3000. In part one of our previous videos, you may have seen us do an actual calibration on a 2019 Volkswagen Golf Alltrack, where we showed a successful completion. In this one, on part two, what we want to show is what would happen if it failed. Stay tuned, we'll go through that next. So right now it said ACC sensor adjustment, not okay. And the things on here it says is possible reasons that the target is misaligned. The sensor is misaligned. The sensor has no clear view or not locked into place or secured. Either way, this video has now turned in from a calibration procedure to what happens if it doesn't pass calibration. So that's what we're gonna focus on for the rest of this video, is trying to figure out why did this not calibrate correctly. What we wanna do now is to verify that we didn't do something ourselves incorrectly with our setup procedures. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do it again just to verify. I don't just wanna assume that there's something wrong with the sensor. I'd rather take the equation of myself out first and go ahead and try it again. So we're gonna walk through the procedure again just to make sure that we have everything where we need to be. So I'm gonna press continue. It did send a report for a post scan, basically a printout saying that it wasn't successful. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna start all over again. So I'm gonna walk back over to our DAS 3000 and we're gonna do this one more time. Before I go back into the front facing radar, I wanna see if I kicked any DTCs. And I also wanna check the actual dash to see if there's any warning lights on real quick. I'm gonna go check the dash and see if anything came up. I did hear a ding after it failed. I wanna see what's going on in there. So we went ahead and checked it out. It says front assist not available in the dash, meaning that adaptive cruise control no longer is working due to the failed calibration. And if I go into my DTCs and perform a DTC scan on my front cruise control system, we're probably gonna have some DTCs. Instead of going through an entire system scan, I'm just going to select the actual adaptive cruise control systems and scan only those. I didn't have a check engine light on or anything like that, so we're gonna continue with that. And it's gonna go ahead and do a DTC scan. This is asking about the radio again. We don't have that style radio. It is factory. So we're good. So it's gonna go through a DTC scan of our adaptive cruise control systems. And obviously there's gonna be some DTCs related to the fact that it just failed a calibration. And we can 00267 on adaptive cruise control is a failed calibration DTC. So again, now that I know that it had a failed calibration, I still wanna go ahead, I'm gonna just do this one more time. I wanna take myself out of the equation, make sure that I didn't miss a step. So we're gonna go through that again and see what happens. Asked us to step away for our second time of calibration. We're going to go ahead and move away from the machine a little bit. It just failed again for a second time. So this wasn't a setup that we had done incorrectly. It did go ahead and give us that indicator that it failed. So what we're going to do now is going to go ahead and find out why is this failing and see if we can come up with what's going on. Asking us to turn the ignition off right now. So I'm gonna do that. So next thing what we're gonna do now is, now that I know I've got a failed or a concern with the actual front radar, Let's go ahead and take a look at that front radar sensor. Let's see if everything looks okay with that. We're gonna head on over to the front of the vehicle and we're gonna take off that Volkswagen emblem. A little special technique to show you how to do that as well. And let's take a look at the condition of this before we dive any further. So let's go ahead and take a look. So again, my ACC radar sensor is back behind this emblem. You don't wanna just grab a pocket screwdriver and just try to pull this off. There is a special way to get this off. I'm gonna show you how to do that. But again, I don't see any damage to the emblem itself. It looks like it's in good condition. Relatively looks maybe like it's been replaced. So that's okay, but we're gonna wanna take this off now and take a look at the actual sensor. So like I said, you don't wanna just pull this off or start prying on it with a screwdriver. There's actually a release tab right through here that if you gently push down on that release tab, it releases the emblem nice and easy. And then you'll pull up on it. Don't pry out on it. It's actually kind of, it's got some hooks. So it sits down and then clamps in. That's what you want to make sure of. And what I did is I was just pushing down on this a little bit and kind of pushing out. That's what allowed this emblem to release. So again, be careful with that or you will damage and break these. So here is our actual adaptive cruise control sensor and the mounting bracket itself. If I'm looking at it right now, I can already tell it's off, it looks like it's not level. I'm gonna go ahead and grab my level and kind of check that right now. And I have a very off reading right now of this angle, of the angle of this sensor. So something looks like it's kind of off whack here. I don't know if the sensor itself or the bracket itself has been damaged, but I have a reading right now of 6.18 degrees. That's not very level at all. So something's going on there. Just doing a quick visual inspection. Did you guys just capture that? Just kind of checking why it felt like if it was loose or anything. That whole sensor just kicked in and clicked into place. And if I check my sensor level again, I went down to 1.6. That changed the angle of this sensor immensely. I'm now at 1.64. I honestly didn't expect to see that where it was obviously was not sitting correctly inside here. You heard that audible click. It must not have been pushed in all of the way, which possibly caused my calibration to fail. I'm willing to bet that's actually what it is, but we'll have to go through the calibration again. I'm gonna need to clear all these DTCs, and now that I have this in place, and I have a better angle of what's going on, we're gonna try that calibration again and see if that took care of it. Fingers crossed on that, that it's that simple of a repair this time. Okay, we put our emblem back on, verified that the AC sensor was in place now, closed our hood back up. I did go ahead and clear all the DTCs in the computer because we did set some on that failed calibration those first go around. So what we're gonna do is go ahead and attempt to recalibrate this a third time. My fingers are still crossed that was the actual issue. I think it was. I'd hate to say it's not the first time I've seen something like that, but it can happen. You always gotta make sure you're double checking your work and taking the time to make sure everything's in place, locked in, into the locking tabs and things like that. So let's go ahead and recalibrate this for the third time and hope that it goes through and that our customer can leave with a working radar system. Thank you. stepped away from the calibration area again for our third time, and we're gonna press continue. Sure, nobody enters the area. Close all the doors. We have talked about all of that. Press continue again. And now it's going to go through the calibration. After we adjust the tilt board, we went ahead and made sure that our tilting lever was centered. Press continue again. It's running the test right now. Please wait. And right there, calibration successfully complete. All right. So again, this went from a simple, we thought this was just gonna be a regular Volkswagen video, to now showing what happens if you fail the calibration. So we've kind of gone through that whole process of making sure we were correct, still failed. Then go ahead and doing a little bit of inspections and finding out that the ACC sensor was not fully seated in its bracket. We saw that the levels were also way off when we went ahead and checked that with our level. And after we've set that all back into place, it's successfully completed. We can press continue now. It's gonna ask us to cycle the ignition on and off. The last thing it asks us to do is again to check and make sure that there's no fault codes in the memory and clear those as needed. And we're back. Meaning that we have done a successful calibration. Now, just like we have talked about in the past, no calibration is complete until you verify it. So we're gonna take this out on the road, do a test drive, make sure that all systems are operating as designed. We're gonna make sure that that cruise control is maintaining that distance in the car in front of it, doesn't allow it to get too close, and maintains that distance and the speed of the car in front of it. We're gonna go ahead and get on a test drive. We'll be back in just a minute. Just got back from our test drive. The adaptive cruise control system is operating normally. No lights on the dash. We were able to maintain a safe speed behind all the cars that we had encountered on the road. I can safely return this car back to their customer. Keep on watching. As the year goes on, we're gonna have a lot more of these ADAS videos and different types of vehicles and different type of procedures as we go on. Thanks for watching. See you next time.